Australia, a country that probably makes you think of its venomous and dangerous animals as soon as you hear its name. One of these creatures is the Inland Taipan, also known as the fierce snake. This elusive creature hails from the arid outback of Australia, and it's not just famous for its venomous bite, but also for its shy demeanor. Despite its fearsome reputation, the Inland Taipan prefers to avoid human contact and is rarely encountered. The Inland Taipan is officially the most venomous snake in the world. Just one bite from this snake packs enough venom to take out around 100 grown men. That's right, 100. But don't worry, these snakes are reclusive and live in the remote parts of Central Australia, so encounters with humans are extremely rare. The venom of the Inland Taipan is a cocktail of neurotoxins, hemotoxins, and myotoxins. Neurotoxins affect the nervous system, causing paralysis. Hemotoxins disrupt blood clotting, leading to internal bleeding, and myotoxins damage muscle tissue. The venom is so potent that it can cause symptoms like convulsions, bleeding, and paralysis if not treated quickly. But let's dig a little deeper. The Inland Taipan's venom is incredibly efficient in its function. The toxins in its venom have evolved to immobilize its prey quickly, ensuring a fast kill. This is crucial because the Inland Taipan primarily preys on small mammals like rodents, which are fast and can escape if given the chance. By immobilizing them swiftly, the snake ensures it doesn't lose its meal. Another interesting fact about the Inland Taipan is its specialized fangs. These snakes have long, hollow fangs located at the front of their mouth, which allow them to inject venom deeply into their prey. These fangs fold back into the mouth when not in use, protecting them from damage and making them more efficient hunters. The Inland Taipan's habitat is a harsh one. They are adapted to the extreme conditions of the Central Australian desert. During the scorching hot days, they take refuge in burrows or under rocks where they stay cool. At night, they emerge to hunt when it's cooler and their prey is more active. Interestingly, despite their reputation, Inland Taipans are not particularly aggressive. They are solitary animals that prefer to avoid confrontation. When threatened, they usually prefer to retreat rather than attack. However, if cornered, they can strike with incredible speed and precision. Snakes are also masters of camouflage. Many species have evolved to blend in with their surroundings, which helps them avoid predators and ambush prey. For example, the Gaboon viper has a beautiful pattern that looks like fallen leaves, allowing it to remain hidden in the forest floor. Another cool fact is that snakes don't have eyelids. Instead, they have a transparent scale called a spectacle that covers and protects their eyes. This spectacle is shed along with their skin during molting. Speaking of molting, snakes shed their skin periodically to grow and remove parasites. Did you know some snakes have a specialized organ called the Jacobson's organ, located in the roof of their mouth? This organ helps them taste the air, which allows them to detect chemical cues from their environment. It's a crucial sense for hunting and navigating their surroundings. Returning to the Inland Taipan, it's worth noting that this snake's venom is not only potent, but also highly specific. Researchers are studying its components to understand how they interact with human biology, which could lead to new medical treatments. For example, understanding the way the venom affects blood clotting could help develop better treatments for blood disorders. The Inland Taipan has a relatively low mortality rate for humans compared to its venom potency. This is due to the fact that antivenoms have been developed and are quite effective. However, this snake's reputation as a deadly predator is well earned, and it's a reminder of the importance of respecting wildlife. Now, let's talk about the price of this deadly concoction. The venom of the Inland Taipan is incredibly valuable, used in research to develop treatments for various medical conditions. A single gram of this venom can be worth up to $5,000. It's fascinating to see how something so deadly can also hold so much potential for good. Before we continue, please like this video because our channel is small and new, and your likes are a huge support for us. All right, next on our list is the cone snail. At first glance, you might think this creature looks harmless, but don't let its shell fool you. The cone snail is a highly effective predator with venom that is both potent and valuable. Cone snails are found in warm, tropical oceans around the world, particularly in coral reefs. They use a harpoon-like tooth to inject venom into their prey, which can be fish, worms, or other snails. The venom is a complex mixture of peptides known as conotoxins, which are so potent they can paralyze their prey almost instantly. Conotoxins are incredibly valuable for research because they target specific receptors in the nervous system, which can help scientists develop new painkillers. In fact, the venom of some cone snails is used to create pain medications that are up to 1,000 times more effective than morphine. Despite its immense value, the venom costs around $100,000 per gram. It's used to study pain management and to develop treatments for various neurological disorders. Cone snails live in the vibrant, colorful reefs of tropical oceans. They are solitary hunters, using their venom to immobilize their prey swiftly before dragging it into their shell for a meal. Some species of cone snails can deliver venom that is fatal to humans, so it's a good idea to admire them from a distance if you ever encounter one. Now, let's get to the grand finale, the Deathstalker Scorpion. This little critter has a reputation that lives up to its name, and its venom is the most expensive of all. The Deathstalker Scorpion is found in North Africa and the Middle East. Its venom is one of the most potent among scorpions and contains a mix of neurotoxins that can cause intense pain, fever, and in severe cases, convulsions. But here's where it gets mind-blowing. A gram of Deathstalker Scorpion venom can sell for up to $39 million. Yes, you heard that correctly. The venom of the Deathstalker Scorpion contains a compound called chlorotoxin, which has shown potential in medical research. Chlorotoxin binds specifically to cancer cells, making it a valuable tool for researchers studying brain tumors and other types of cancer. This venom's unique properties have placed it at the forefront of cancer research, making it incredibly valuable. These scorpions thrive in extreme desert environments where they have adapted to survive high temperatures during the day and cold temperatures at night. They're nocturnal hunters, using their pincers to grab prey and their venomous stinger to deliver a potent dose of toxins. Their role in the ecosystem is crucial, helping to keep insect populations in check. To recap, we've explored venoms from the Inland Taipan, Cone Snail, and Deathstalker Scorpion. In the world of science, these venoms are treasures. Researchers are using them to develop new treatments for pain, cancer, and more. It's amazing to think how something so dangerous can lead to breakthroughs that save lives and improve health. Let's put this into perspective. Gold costs around $60 per gram, and even the rarest perfumes or truffles can't compete with these venoms' price tags. But even the cone snail's $100,000 per gram is overshadowed by the Deathstalker Scorpion's jaw-dropping $39 million per gram. And if you think these venoms are expensive, you probably haven't heard about antimatter yet. Antimatter is used in high-energy physics research, and its production and storage are incredibly difficult, making its price a staggering $62.5 trillion per gram. Unbelievable, right? We can make a video all about antimatter and explain everything about it, but making it depends on your interest. So if you're into it, let us know in the comments so we can cover it in a future video. For those of you who have been with us here, I recommend checking out this video by our team where we explain what if honeybees go extinct. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed sharing it with you. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and until the next video, stay curious and full of energy.